Then we also have conflicts in India, for example, dams and displacement. That is one of the very important conflicts. You take any project, there's a conflict. So we have tried to document some of it, like including the Sardar Sarovar project, which is one of the very major conflicts in type of a thing. And try to see what are the type of approach we can develop.
There's a cat. In the tree. Or no, it's a wall. Okay.
Yeah. So, two things which you were saying in the as an approach to deal with this type of conflicts. One is that, is the project necessary?
Mm-hmm.
That's a question we need to ask. Or is there any alternative ways of meeting the water needs through local water harvesting or watershed development and other type of thing? And a larger water source project development should be planned only if all the other local decentralized options are exhausted. Second thing is that instead of, we are also saying, okay, even if then there's a need to create certain water storages, can we create that in a decentralized manner? Instead of now, in the present, what you call the established method is that you have a massive dam, the entire water use, planned water use, the water required for the water use is stored behind one dam.
Yes.
Instead of that, what we can do is that, for example, you have a dam and your service area is this one outside. So what you do is that you create a water storage only up to a level where the canal takes off so that the water can go through the canal and things. And most of the water needs to be stored in the command area itself. Otherwise, what happens is that one section of people pay the price for the submergence and displacement, and another set of people benefit.
Mm-hmm.
Now, for example, most of the dams are located in the mountainous areas and things where the Adivasi, the tribals live. Now, they don't get any benefit of this water. Water goes into the agriculture community, mostly. And they are the caste groups like Patels or Marathas or other type of people who are basically agriculturists and type of thing. So we are saying that if they are going to get benefit of the water, they should also pay a price for submergence. So during the monsoon or the post-monsoon months up to December or January, you can divert this water through the high-level canal to the service area of the project. You can create smaller, you know, you already have certain lot of storage structures there in case of mine irrigation tanks and other type of structures and type of things. So use those structures to store your share of water there, and you have those points of the water distribution.
Mm-hmm.
Don't create a massive water body behind one structure and irrigate from there. So if you have this type of decentralized type of a thing, then the displacement and the submergence can be brought down to the minimum to some extent. So you need to explore options of that type, so that our principle is that we need to minimize both the social and the ecological costs.
Mm-hmm.
And things. So you can have a different technical and managerial options today to a much more decentralized system of water storage and distribution thing that is possible. And we have come up with an alternative for the Sardar Sarovar project. There's a book on that that Suhasini has written,
yes,
which gives this option. The third principle is that they have proper, meaningful rehabilitation for people who are going to be displaced. Now, even if the second option is accepted, saying that we have less displacement or less submergence, there may be few people still may be displaced. Now, how do you treat them? India's track record of doing rehabilitation is pretty bad. Now, there are projects which have been completed 50, 60, 70 years back, still more than 40-50% of the people are not rehabilitated. Like most of the states, like in Maharashtra, for example, they are supposed to be given land for land.
Yes.
If I lose land, then I should get land. And they also say that that land has to be with irrigation facility. Then plus one person of the family should be given a guaranteed employment. And when the new houses are built or the new village settlement takes place there, you know, where the rehabilitation is done, you should get some 20 or 21 type of civic amenities which should be created. Like drinking water facility, roads,
electricity,
gram panchayat, health, educational and other type of thing. Most of these things will take place unless there is a movement which is going to force them and type of thing. So a proper development-centered rehabilitation is a major precondition if you have to go for this type of thing. So we have come up with, in the review article of the cases, how do you deal with this type of thing. So
yeah,
it's a three-pronged approach which you are trying to take.
And just
yeah,
a quick
yeah
question. What happens to people who haven't received compensation for 50, 40, 60 years?
They all basically work as agriculture laborers, or they go to the cities as, you know, migration type of thing.
Yeah, because that's down to generational time.
Yeah, it's a generational issue. There are two generations might have already gone. in the, you know, search of getting the proper compensation, the rehabilitation. So unless now, because that is also very militant sections today, they are getting organized very well.
Mm-hmm.
So wherever there's organized type of movements of these people, some of the things they've been able to get. But places where there's no organization to back them up, they have been just left to fend for themselves. So that is